taking care of the inner self. Mamedi arate hang tsatsing lena re tlo bua hore re ke re leke ho tibisa maikutlo, re ke re leke ho itlhatlhoba, to go deep within ourselves and to examine ourselves. Hore tsatsi lena re ke re itlhatlhobe re bone hore ke eng se re tsang re be ditshila na, ke eng se sa etseng re be le kgotso within ourselves. And that is why mamedi a ratang ke kgethile lentswe lena fankgeding ya Mateo, Matthew chapter 15 verse 18 to 20. Empa ha o e bala kaofela the rest of Matthew chapter 15, o tla elellwa with the Pharisees, their concern about, you know, their, you know, Puritan laws, the purity rules or rituals. What defiles a person? Ke eng se etsang hore motho a seke a hlweka? And so most of them, they were always concerned with external observation of the law, the external observation of the rules of purity. Hore ba ihlwekisa yang. Empa mrena Jesu o bua ntho e bohlokwa mamedi a ratehang tsatsing lena, hore ntho e etsang motho a silafale, or what defiles a person, it is not that so much it comes from the outside, but it is what comes from the heart. Hobane bothata bo pelong, from our inner self. And that is the only thing that you also have a, you know, you have, you know, a point, you have, you know, control over your inner self. And most of the problems, most of the time, hare sheba mathata a etsala mo maphelong a rona, we always want to look at the outside. We never want to go within ourselves to check our hearts. Hore ana dipelo tsa rona ke pelo tse hlwekileng, jwalo ka mo pesalema are mpopele pelo e hlwekileng, o ho morena. Create a pure heart for me, O God. And that is why tsatsing lena re bua ka yona, the inner self, our hearts, ka mo ho rona, ke eng se tswang ka mo ho rona. We want to purify, we want to check our inner self, we want to release ourselves from the prisons that we have imprisoned ourselves within. Hobane ba bangata ba rona, yes, we are free, yes, we are walking outside there, yes, we are smiling, but within ourselves there's so much brokenness, there's so much pain, there's so much bitterness, there's so much anger. Dipelong tsa rona, ka botebong ba rona, ka hare ho rona, we want to take care of the inner self, we want to take care of the inside, ourselves, from deep within. Morena Jesu, are take care, because most of the things that defile a person, it is what comes from the heart. Se tswang pelong. Morena Jesu qala ka the evil thoughts, a re le mehopolo e mebe wena ngwane so ya ratehang. What are some of the things? Ke di ndi ntho tse di mo bophelong ba hao tse tswang, you know, from within yourself, from your inner self, the thoughts that you have. Hore mo bophelong ba hao, when you have time, when you think about life, when you think about other people, your relationship with God, your relationship with your brothers and sisters, what are some of the thoughts that come to your mind? And most of the time, because, you know, sometimes we let our thoughts to go so wild that we allow the temptation to take over, so that our thoughts are not on our own growth. After the heart of God, to be people after the heart of God. And so sometimes we have these evil thoughts. Today, the word is saying, as we take care of our inner self, let us cultivate a culture of positivity. Let us look within ourselves. Let us allow our thoughts not to be controlled, not to be dominated by negativity. Speak positive, you know, speak positive thoughts, you know, speak positively to your life. Look at your situation. Be otshana le morena modimo. You know, when we are said how to, we are created in the image and likeness of God, so that you and I might have the mind of Christ. within us. So that nalwena, we must speak positive, you know, positivity into whatever situation ere tobana leona. Speak anointing, speak blessings. The evil thoughts, they do not come from outside. Impa, these thoughts, they come from the inside. Let us take care of our inner self. Let us take care of zinto tsetswang ka ho rona, mehopolo menahano ya rona. Let us have positive thoughts instead of negative thoughts. Let us be, you know, when God was creating the world, he was saying, let there be, let there be. Ke eng seo se batlang mo bophelong ba hao. Speak life into whatever that you want into your life. Let there be this, whatever that you speak, you know, positivity. Speak life, let there be. Let there be. You are a child of God. You have the word of God within you. You are powerful. Speak life into every situation. O batlang hore dintho di etsahale ka moo Morena Modimo le ena a ratang ka teng. Morena Jesu a re murder. All these things, they come from the inside. Murder, adultery, unchastity, false witness. You know, gossip, all these things, they come from the heart. We are not taking care of our inner self because we allow. This is where all these things come, because within the heart, there is a war. Within the heart, there is a contest between good and bad. Dintotsena dialwantsana. That is why tsatsinlena kere hwena ngwane so ya ratehang. Your inside matters. Your heart, your inner self, looking within yourself to say as a person, ha ke motho fela ya tsohang, ha ke motho fela who just goes with the flow. Empa ke motho, a person of reflection, a person of self introspection, to say, is my heart, you know, is my heart, you know, moving me in a direct, in a good direction. Where within myself, when I look at myself, when I look at my inner being, am I a person, you know, who's content? Anaki mutu yalale khotso, anaki mutu ya tititeng from within. Am I a person? Do I have that stability? Do I have that? Do I feel in touch with my inner being? The inner sanctuary, where we find even the voice of God planted deep within our heart. Your inside, your inner self matters. Do not neglect useke wa lebala hore uma from deep within yourself, your inner being, it matters. It is the sanctuary of your being, the dwelling place of God, where you get your power, not outside. Mani ka ntle ngwaneso, you'll not get the power. You'll not get the energy of God. The energy of God comes from within. And that is why we need to be in touch with our inner self, in touch with our inner being, our heart. Mona butibong badi pelo tsa rona from within ourselves. Ke eng he ngwaneso? Morena Jesu are. All these things, murder, adultery, unchastity, false, all these things, they defile us, that we think they come from the, these things, they come from the inside. What is it that is eating you from the inside? Ke eng se sa etseng o robale? Ke eng se sa o phomotseng? Ke eng se o kgathatsang? From within your inner self. Hobaneng o sa tsitsa. Yes, maybe ngwaneso, you have to going ena re khutlele morao. Jwale ka re boelana le Morena Modimo wa rona, to go back and to say, what is it that is eating me from the inside? Maybe it is bitterness. I don't know. Maybe you are bitter. Maybe there's something that has happened in your life. Mobu pilomba how hunalin totse tsahetseng. You have never really enjoyed peace. You don't have joy. You are bitter. Maybe it is sickness. Maybe, yes, you are sick. Maybe you have, you know, unaluhuku langwanesu, and this thing is eating you from the inside. Your health conditions as well. Maybe you are a person who has anger. ona le khalefo. There are certain things, whether it could be childhood trauma, whether it could be things that have happened, hona jwale mo bophelong ba hao. Yes, you have anger. It is boiling within you. It is, you know, it is starting to eat you up. How sana bophelo? Yes, sometimes, yes, dintho di etsahala ka mo sa rateng ka teng. And yes, sometimes you feel that you are justified. You feel that, you know, I have a right to feel this way. We are not saying neglect your feelings, but be careful. Horinto enu isike ya hoja. Unforgiveness are tshwarele. Re qadile lenaneo ka thapelo e re kopang tshwarelo ho Morena Modimo. What is eating you from the inside? Take care of your inner being. Take care of your inside. Mohlomong lenyalo mane hona le mathata. Maybe you have marriage issues, relationship issues with your brothers and sisters, with your friends, with your partner. What is eating you from the inside? Do not allow it hore e ho qete ntho eno. Maybe there are household issues, financial issues. Rabona ngwane sore le dintho maemo a bophelo, you know, the life conditions, re bona le bophelo, the standard of living, things are becoming expensive. All these things, they can have also a negative impact mo maphelong a rona, or impact our peace, the inner peace that we all yearn for, the joy that we want. Work conditions, your work conditions, most of it and thing. Maybe una leading talk that you are not happy about, things that are not going according to the way you'd wish that they go. What is eating you from the inside? My dear friend, ngwaneso ya rata ya mamedi wa boelana le Morena, do not allow those things ho di huje di uqete. Take care of your inner self. How about a Proverbs chapter 14 verse 30? It says, a calm and undisturbed mind and heart are the life and health of the body, but envy and jealousy are the wrath, and wrath are like the rottenness of the bones. Jealousy and envy are like the rottenness, kapa the cancer of the bones. Don't let your inside to rot. Uske wa dumela, you know, your inner self, hore o bole from within the inside, because once you have o dumeletse pelo ya hao e bole, e bodiswe ke tsona dintho tsena tse ke buang ka tsona. Once you have allowed your heart to go into that, you know, that condition, hore e bodiswe ke tsona dintho tsena, whatever that comes out of your mouth, it will not be good. Whatever that comes out of your mouth, it will destroy. It will destroy your own dreams. It will destroy your own family. It will destroy even your own relationships. Leba tubo pilan lebona. Yes, ngwaneso. Yes, it may be painful. Yes, you might be going through trauma. Yes, you might be going through pain. Yes, you might be going through all these emotions. Mobu pelomba how din totse tango skaba libu tito kahare. You know that, you know, stability, inner peace and joy. Yes, sometimes there can be those conditions. But we want to say today, mo boelana le Morena. Yes, it's not fair, but the word of God is saying, let us take care of our inner being. Let us take care of our heart, because it is from there that we will, you know, we will move with the energy of God. We will free ourselves from a prison. We'll free ourselves and realize that we have been saved. In hope, we are saved. Jwale ka apostola Paulo se abua, hore we have been saved by the power of the cross, the death, the saving death of our Lord Jesus Christ, the power of the resurrection of Jesus. We are no longer prisoners. We are no longer slaves. We are no longer under the yoke of sin. You are a free child of God. Allow yourself to control. Huna le dintho outside mo bophelong that you cannot control. Huna le dintho tse tsahalang ngwaneso maphelong a rona that are beyond your control. And sometimes you try and try, but your inner self, it is within your control. It is within your domain. It is a territory that you are in charge, because you have been empowered by the Spirit of God. Choose freedom, not slavery. choose freedom, not slavery. Luke chapter 6, verse 28, it says, bless those who curse you. Pray for your enemies. Speak blessings, anointing, and blessings. And that is the way of being a Christian. Mwanesu, it is not easy, but it is possible. Because we serve a powerful God, the Alpha and Omega. The one who knows our destiny. The one who empowers us by the power of the Holy Spirit. Yena yare matlafatsa Morena Modimo. Today, hare boela na le Morena Modimo. We want to lift up our hearts and our minds to worship Him. We want to lift up, you know, to present ourselves before His ever glorious face, the throne of mercy, the God who says to us today, my child, Mwanaka, hlokomela pelo ya hao. Look at your inner self, your inside. Take care of yourself. You have the power over your life because I've given you this life. He is the life giver, the Alpha and Omega. Alo leqetelo. But the things that come out of the mouth come from the heart, and they defile. For from the heart comes evil thoughts, murder, adultery, unchastity, theft, false witness, blasphemy. These are all the things that defile a person. What comes from the heart? Today we want to pray. Re rapele mamedi mo leng teng re morena. Se ka dumela go dipelo tsa rona di bole. Bobodu bo re bo bonang sechabeng, bobodu bo re bo bonang dipolitiking, bobodu bo re bo bonang diphuthego mo re iphumanang teng, the corruption that we see, it all stems from the heart. Once we allow the heart gore pelo e bole, you know, everything will come. Yes, maybe you are fighting battles, mamedi. Yes, maybe of what has happened mo bophelong ba hao. And we have allowed that hatred to shape your heart. Today we want to pray and say, God, re thuse o re hlatswe from within. Ke tlo bula mehala mamedi mohlomong lentswe lena la ka jeno mohlomong molaetsa ena ka jeno o bua le wena. Ke tlo bula mehala on 011-452-7115. Or oreletsetse o ke o bue le nna kapa you want to share a testimony, you are most welcome. Kapa ngwa le melaetsa on WhatsApp on 0742062606 2074206 2606. Take care of your inner self. Take care of the inside. And I'm reminded by the interview that I had last time with Vanessa Guzen, who was arrested for almost 16 and a half years. Kanto ane asaetsa, a iphumana a le tshankaneng. Prison for 16 years. She was chained. She was praying for freedom. She was praying hore a fumane tokoloho from those chains, a real prison, mamedia ratehang. In her book, are at some point, she had to learn to choose the freedom that comes from within. That even though she would be in prison, there would be moments of joy because she had to experience the inner freedom. And she says in her book, I learned that you choose what you hold on to and what you get rid of. Mamedi kgetho e ho wena. The power is with you. She says, I learned that, you know, with all this experience, all the pain, all the tears, all the sleepless nights, I learned that in life, you choose what you hold on to and what you get rid of. Ke eng se o tshwareletseng ho sona? You know, ke eng se o tshwareletseng sona? From within the inner self, that you are not experiencing the freedom of being the child of God. Are one day, she continues in her book and she says, one day I woke up and I realized that I've been fighting for so long. Mamedi, maybe you have been fighting. Maybe, you know, you are not forgiving. You are still angry. You know, with all those things, allow God to fight for you. You have been fighting for so long. My sister, my brothers, you have been fighting for so long. Take care of the inner self. Allow God to fight for you. Ore fela ntate nhlatswe lena ngigese inkosi yami ngibe muhle nami.
I just want to leave you with a word to say, you know, in this world, we will have many trials. We go through many trials and tribulations. But God says we must be of good cheer. He has overcome the world and so will we. So don't allow the devil to steal what belongs to you. Stay close to God. That is how I survived 16 and a half years in prison. And that is up until today how I survive my situations is by staying close to God, having a relationship with God. This time is not a time to pretend. This time is not a time to play Christian. This time is not a time to play church. This is the time where God is shaking, where God is sifting, where God is separating. Do not miss what God has in store for you. Strengthen what remains. Believe and trust in God. Hold on to your faith. Love, forgive, serve God. Walk in your calling, whatever He has called you to do. Fulfill your calling, because that is what God has called us, and that is the reason why He has put us on this earth. Do not allow your situation or your circumstances to control you, overpower you, and destroy you. Everybody in this world are facing situations. But God says in His word, even if the whole earth will disappear, His word will remain the same. So you can trust His word. Yes, we can't trust people. They will fail you. But God will never fail us. His word will never fail us. Hold on to His promises. Not just sing a song. Not just pray. Not only read the word. Implement the word. Understand the word. Believe the word. Trust in God. Know that you are a child of God, and whose you are and whose you belong to. When you know who you are and who you belong to and who your Father is, there's nothing that can shake you or move you away from believing and trusting in God.